everyone, hello YouTube, this is Felipe, or Gap to the South, and today I'm here with another dance tip for you. I am going to talk about something very important that many dancers neglect or don't even know about. I'm going to teach you the difference between active and passive movements. Okay, so I already gave you a little bit of the introduction and what we're doing today, but I actually want to tell you how I became aware of active and passive movements. Maybe if you're a classically trained or if you are a trained dancer, you might have heard of this before, and it might even have a different name in English, but I know it from my time as a child when I used to do tap dance. I remember very well, we had a performance coming up. It was the end of the year performance from our entire dance school. And my tap dance teacher, Carolina Lobato, I don't know if she's ever going to see this video, but if she does, she would also refer to it as dead movements or live movements. And I'm going to try to show it to you in different contexts. Now, when I see people in my classes, or when I see videos of people dancing, I realize that many Samba dancers nowadays are not aware of this difference. And it makes the world of a difference. We are going to have a look into arms, we are going to have a look into poses, we are going to have a look into jumps, we are going to have a look into walks, and we are going to have a look into the regular basic Samba step. Okay, so what exactly do I mean by active and passive, dead or alive movement? So basically, if you take my arm, for example, I'm just holding out my arm on my side like this. Right now, I am not really putting a lot of effort. I am not using all of my muscle power that I have to hold out my arm. I'm basically just holding it out from my turkey, if you don't know what it is. I'll make sure I'll put a link to the turkey video right here so you can watch it. I'm just holding out my arm from here, but other than that, I'm not really doing anything. Now, watch the magic. I would say that this is a passive pose of my arm. For me to turn it active, I have to activate my muscles that are here when I'm holding out my arm. So look, 5, 6, 7, 8, boom. I don't know, you probably can't see very much because I'm a very muscular guy, but I activated my muscle and I can see the line from my bicep. When we are dancing, let's say I'll have a very easy combo, something that I do all the time, which is an affondo, a cross, a step, maybe a turn, and a jump, okay? So let's go with the passive arms first, doing this very easy combo, okay? Here we go, and. I'm just holding them here. Now I'll try to actively use my arms when that's in this combo. Everything is active, everything is in pose. Let's have a look into some classic Samba poses, all right? So, first Samba pose is this. Now you can have your arm out or in, like this. I automatically already activate my turkey, my legs, my arms, and I'm not just standing there, okay? Another classic Samba pose, this. Also here, for me, it's very difficult to do it passive because my body is so used. Let me try here. So I'm just holding out my arms. I'll just even remove the turkey just so I can see, show to you how some people look. No turkey. No active arms, no active legs. I'm just standing here, okay, in the pose. Now let's fix this pose. Turkey, active arms, active legs, and an active smile. Another pose to the side. Also here, Of course, my legs are already activated because they're holding my entire body, but this one doesn't have to be active. But if I actually want to activate it, it looks a lot nicer right away, okay? So I'm here on my legs, I'm activating my turkey, I can keep my arms here. If I want to have an arm out, I can also activate it, make it live, or even like more dramatic. But it's always about putting life into your movement and not just holding out. You see, when it comes to posing, especially at the end of the class, sometimes I count like 5, 6, 7, 8, pose. And I see that people, 5, 6, 7, 8, pose. I'm like, come on, 5, 6, 7, 8, pose. And you have all this liveliness in your pose. Now, the next thing we're going to look at are the jumps. Can you actually jump not being active? Believe me, some people manage, I don't know how. But quick sequence, quick combo, just for you to have an idea. I'm going to have an afunda here, and I'm going to jump over here, all right? Now, some people would just leave the jump out. But even if I'm jumping, some people just jump and fall down because they're not active in their body. So it's really like, again. When you're trying to activate your body, you're taking an active afunda. You're going to have an active jump, bringing your heel all the way up. And you land soft because you have your entire body, your back, your turkey, in place and active. So I'll repeat that a couple times. I'm also stretching and pointing my feet when I'm doing this. On the back. So this is a very important thing as well, because it's going to make your dancing look alive. Okay? Good. Alright, the next one is so crucial. I do not understand. I have no place in my heart for people who do not walk actively. I'll try to walk without activating my legs and my entire body very slow. Alright, now let's have a look how an active walk actually looks. I want to use all of my leg muscles. I want to use all of my back muscles. I want to use my arms to really walk into stage. People are going to see that you don't mean what you're doing, but when you walk, like, and this is the big difference between international passistas and Brazilian passistas, in my opinion. They do know how to do the active part, okay? No critics and no generalizing, but this is something that you should be aware of, especially when you're walking, okay? Last but not least, let's have a look into the active and passive samba step, shall we? The passive samba step would actually have less hip movement, in my opinion, so I'll turn around. Whereas the active will definitely go boom, 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 boom. Really use power in your hips. That's only concerning the hips. I also have the posture. If I have a passive dead posture here, with dead arms. And if I really activate the posture, activate my arms, this makes the entire difference. Now, the interesting thing is, when you're dancing the samba step, here you have to be careful when you're playing with active or passive arms, because you can also come across very hard, very stiff, if you make very active arms. Let's have a look into that. I'll dance samba slowly with passive dead arms first. My movement is coming from my turkey. I am not putting any effort in stretching or bending my arms at all. It's just happening naturally for me. Now this looks actually soft. Yeah. If I were to do this at this speed, active, it would look something like this. Which actually makes it heavier. So for slow samba, it's important to have an active turkey but passive arms. I know this is getting complicated. For fast samba, however, if you're really going fast, you activate your turkey, you activate your arms to get more impulse, okay? Let me try to show it to you. Whew. And time, and.
Mangueira, samba, teu samba é uma reza pela força que ele tem. Mangueira, vou te cantar meus pecados, mas eu estou do seu lado, do lado do samba
também. Anyway, 30 seconds and I'm dying. This is what the quarantine does to everyone. God. Anyway, when you're dancing fast samba, you most probably are going to need active arm movements, okay? Because this is going to give you the impulse you need to lift off the ground and give your hip space to move. Anyway, I hope you guys could enjoy this video. If you did, make sure you leave a like and subscribe to my channel to motivate me to keep doing this, and activate the notification button so you know that there's another video on the way out to you with more nice tips and information about our beautiful summer world. So take care and I'll see you next time. Bye!